Welcome, coffee farmer. My name is Bernard Dongo from Fadhili Africa. We are experts in soil testing.
We as Fadhili Africa, we use digital machines. They are called soil scanners. This is another technology that is used to test the soil, and you're able to get the results on site. This machine is rechargeable, and it works hand in hand with an application that is found on the phone, which we are going to connect the charger and the phone so that you can be able to test. And we do connect them using Bluetooth, which, as you can see, is up, is on here. So we connect using the Bluetooth. And the first thing that we do is to first calibrate the machine, and we calibrate it using the calibration cup. The first thing that we are going to do is to connect the machine together with the calibration cup white side, and this one is used to erase any information that was there before for the previous sample. And once we have connected the scanner and the machine, the scanner is controlled now by the application. So at this stage, now the scanner is connected. We are going now to connect as guided by the application, and we are going to press the scan button first. That's going to scan the white side, and after the white side, we will scan the yellow side, so that we make sure that this machine is now in proper and good working condition before we get into the sample. As this is happening, we are going to take a soil sample from the bucket. Remember, we took this sample from the soil, from the farm, directly from the farm, and we are going to pick using our soil cup that has the amount that it's supposed to take. And as part of preparation, this is ready and it is good. It is now time to change to the yellow side. We change to the yellow side, we change the machine to the yellow side, connect properly, and then we press the scan button, and then we wait for the direction. Once it is through, it will ask for the sample. And as you can see, it's a quick process. It is free from human error. The accuracy here is better because all issues that come with wet chemistry are eliminated at this stage. So we are through, and the machine, as you can see here, it has a video so that the operator can be able to see. Number two, it has the direction that are written. So whoever the person we have and we have been able to train cannot make mistakes, because the total control of the machine is by the application. So we are now getting into the stage one of the analysis, and we put the scanner on the soil and we press the scan button. As you can see here, we are already in stage one, and once it is through with the stage one, it will put a tick. The scan button here will stop. I will just see green color, and then we'll wait for the machine to pick what is on the soil. It uses infrared, near infrared light. And you know, generally, when you are using the general, in the normal laboratory, we use a spectroscope, and this is an improved technology of spectroscope. Now we get into stage two. So the first thing that we do is we are going to remove the machine from the soil, put it back into our bucket, then mix again. We mix thoroughly. Then from there, we take another sample. And we are going to repeat this one for 5 times. Second time, we are putting the machine again on the soil sample, and then we connect again and wait for the scanner to finish doing its work. The machine does 5 times so that it can be able to improve the level of accuracy. It takes the average of the total, and that's what we submit to the crowd, so that we are able now to get back the result in 5 minutes. Now 5 minutes are over, so the application here is asking for now the details of the farmer. We are going to get the details of the farmer, in which you are going to input now the name of the farmer, then the next one is the telephone number. We know he is in Kenya. We had his country called Kenya. From there, we put the PO box and the email address. Then we go to the next one. The next one is that we want to know the specific field which is here. And this farm is the Block 1 of this farmer. which is 2 acres. We put 2 acres, and then we pick the GPS for exact position here, so that even if somebody else in our company wants to come and visit this farm, you'll be guided by the GPS and you come directly to here. Then after that, we go to the crop that the farmer is doing, and so we are going to pick coffee. From coffee, we are doing it in 2 acres. And that's it. We send now the report, and we just complete this as an order. And once this one we have completed, it just registers in our office that that job has been done. And within a few minutes, we are going to get to the report, so that we can now take you through to what we have found with this farm. Let me open. Now, as you can see, the report is now back. It is here. It's quick. And what we want to see is that we want to know the first status of this soil. And as you can see from here, the soil fertility table tells us a few things. There are 6 key and important things that we check. Number one is the soil acidity. And as you can see from this report here, this soil is acidic. And that explains a number of few things that we have observed in the farm, and we need to take care of them. The second thing we look at is the organic carbon, and here we are talking about manure, and you can see that the farmer requires to add more manure in the farm, and we encourage farmers to keep adding manure in their farms. And then we look at the status of total nitrogen that is in the sample, then also total phosphorus, total potassium, and the last one is what explains about cation exchange capacity, and we are talking about how available are these nutrients that are already in the soil to the crop. It's a critical thing, and we need to look at it. The next thing that we look at in the next table is how we are going to correct the issues that we have found with this farm. And number one, we are saying during the dry season, the farmer is required to add lime into this farm to fight the acidity. The next one is on adding the manure, which we have given him the specific quantities that he's supposed to add. And then we know that we are heading into the season in which the coffee is going to do flowering. And so we have given him specifically the fertilizer that he is going to use, as well as the quantity. Remember, the one of the essence is to remove the guesswork in our farming, because farming is a science. So before flowering, we want to give him enough nutrient that will allow his coffee to flower to its biological potential, and then after that we go to the next stage, which is actually the stage of fruit growth. And in this one, you have the small seeds that are expanding. We want to feed this seed so that it will expand, and we make sure that we maintain good quality of that seed, and good quality and also good weight for the same. Then finally, we got to the stage at which this coffee is well grown. As you can see, the seeds are already green. And now we are heading to the last part of it, in which it is required to now ripen. So we recommend what fertilizers will allow the coffee to ripen evenly, and also be able to shorten the harvesting period. And finally, after that, we do harvesting. We harvest, and when we harvest, we are actually injuring the crop. We are injuring the plant. And also, you know, in coffee farming, we also do pruning at the same time. That means we have caused more woods on that crop, and we need to feed the crop so that they can heal and be able further to prepare for another flowering season. Then finally, what we do is that, as you can see in the last table, we give the emojis that signify what crops can be able to grow well in that soil. As you can see, because of the various issues, we saw the organic matter had issues, pH had issues, the cation exchange had also issues. Then those are things that we need to modify and take care of for us to be able to optimize production, and that would mean that we have higher level of production, as well as we talk about income, and that makes it a business like any other business that this farmer is doing.